Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman. Ms. Brooks LaSure, thanks for reaching out. I enjoyed our conversation. As I told you, I was going to follow up on dual eligibles, not as a gotcha question, but rather just kind of to explore it. We both know that we spend a lot of money in this country on duals, and we get miserable outcomes. Now, duals are a heterogeneous population, both in terms of who they are medically, but also in terms of the method by which they are financed. But one thing you pointed out in our conversation is the difficulty in aligning the incentive for the state and the federal government. The ACA attempted to address the duals, and yet I don't think it worked. Can you give a little bit of a kind of lessons learned from the ACA's attempt to address the lack of alignment among duals?
Senator Cassidy, I very much appreciated our conversation and enjoyed the opportunity to talk. As we talked about, dual eligibles are the sometimes the most vulnerable in our society in terms of comorbidities, often very expensive for both the Medicare and the Medicaid program. I think that as we talked about, greater alignment is something that we are going to need to continue to work with. Some of that can be done by CMS administratively with getting the program.
But let me ask you particularly, what were the lessons learned from the ACA's effort? Because I think Minnesota may have been the only state in which their particular program worked. And so again, I'd like to build upon what we've learned. What have we learned?
I would say I would, you know, want to look at the valuation, particularly around Minnesota. But what I would say is there still is a need to coordinate better on what we see in long-term care and the nursing homes and hospitalization. And that's some of that is going to take a legislation and really thinking about how do we treat people on the continuum. So particularly in assisted living, PACE programs, things, I think there's more we can do to encourage that kind of coordination.
Ms. Palm, you've been kind of on front and center of this in your jobs in Wisconsin. What thoughts do you have about the duals?
Mm-hmm. I appreciate the question and your point about the different financing and states and the feds working together for us. We were very focused on the continuum of long-term care services and providing the opportunity for patients, for seniors, people with disabilities, to choose care that best met their needs with the greatest amount of independence. And our ability to do that most effectively and efficiently would benefit from, as Ms. Brooks LaSure mentioned, greater alignment as you are sort of driving towards.
Let me just kind of stop you for a second. I think one of the things that happened in California is that there was an incredible amount of churn. People got assigned to a program, I think run by Medicaid, but with a Medicare, I may have this wrong, you guys may know I'm correct, but the so-called patient choice ended up being churned where people were changing from program to program several times within a year, which of course destroys continuity of care, and it begs the question as to whether or not the decision as to where to receive care was informed or whether it was perhaps influenced by those who had other agendas. Any thoughts upon this? Is there a way to address that? I'll start with you, Ms. Palm.
Yeah, I would say, Senator, we saw much more churn in our non-long-term care population in Wisconsin. I'm not saying that that's what you're raising isn't an issue.
I'm saying among duals in general. Duals in general.
Yeah, I think that sort of to your fundamental point. Continuity of care coordination, making sure that we're putting patients at the center of the care they're receiving, and doing what we can to do that.
I guess
efficiently.
I'm not making my point, Ms. Palm. Everything you're saying is true. What I'm trying to get at is how do we address the churn?
Well, I think Senator, from our perspective in Wisconsin, we wanted to make sure that the products that were available and the choices that seniors had were that it was transparent on the front end, that they understood them, and that when they made their choice, they made a good choice for them, there wasn't a need to change on a continuous basis.
So what was your rate of churn in Wisconsin? I'm just curious. I don't know that answer.
Again, I'm not sure I can remember off the top of my head in long-term care versus in the regular population, but I would be happy to get that information back to you, Senator.
Okay, I yield back. Thank you.